Hello. Today's something a little bit different. Gonna take a quick break from Mass Effect to do something a little bit different. This game's actually a few years old now. It came out a few years ago. It's one that I actually backed on Kickstarter. As a result, there is a comment from me in the game. I will tell you where it is. Quick content warning, which the game itself will provide in a minute. This game is about a toxic relationship. So there is a fair bit of manipulative dialogue and gaslighting and stuff like that going on. So entirely possible that a fair number of you may end up being kind of bothered by the content. Some of you anyway. Some of you may end up being bothered by the content. So it's totally okay to not watch this if that's the sort of thing that you think might bother you. Very small creative team here. It does also provide some resources. And as an additional note, 20% of the proceeds of this game went towards Atira Women's Resources Society, which provides trans-inclusive transitional housing to women in British Columbia. That is upside down. Oh, okay. In this game, you play as Josh's girlfriend, Carly. After long shifts at the hospital as a nurse, she's become accustomed to nodding along each night when he calls to talk about his day. What unfolds on this night may not be comfortable. Are you sure you wish to continue? Press space anytime to pause or quit. I may do that just to get through some of the additional content. Re, how you doing, babe? Hey, Mamasa. Yeah, I get what you're saying. I'm just tired. Really tired. I have work and I have sleep and I have what little I can give to other people squeezed in between. Every year when my birthday comes around, I realize how little energy I have. People give me such awesome gifts that they put so much time into, and I can't remember the last time I had the energy to do that. Not since high school. When I first met Josh, he didn't ask for shit like that. He got excited about planning dates and preparing little surprises for me, and all I had to do was be there and listen to him talk and enjoy the sun and the beach or wherever he took me. It's not him, it's me. I'm burnt out and I'm being too sensitive. Ugh. I don't want to think about this right now. Emergency at the hospital has been hell this last month. Maybe let's chat next week. Love from across the country, Carly. Dues and new collective agreement update. Notice any nurses who previously not paid dues, as new collective agreement has been reached with St. Polonius Hospital. Blah blah blah. Naloxone kits in a morgue. Besides that, we've finally been given the green light to hand out naloxone to those patients coming in to emerge.
Hey!
I just had a week. I would call it a week.
Yeah.
Jim came over to my desk today, second time this week, to tell me, again, to put Helvetica to rest.
That sucks.
And, I mean, you know that I've been working hard on this. You know I've been pushing this. And Jim, oh God, Jim, does he ever know that I've bled for this? I know I've said this a million times, but I just feel as though we're all trapped in this toxic culture around health, you know? And for Jim to just dismiss that, without consideration, without even trying to claw out the manure that's been crusting in his ears, and that's been crusting in everyone's ears, without even giving me the chance?
Bossa Nova.
I mean,
the soft breeze and the trembling strings of your heart.
What kind of person does that make him, right?
Did he say what?
Yeah, he wants Tractor Dad pushed out the door.
Yes, they need to focus on what's making the money.
And you can bet Tractor Dad's making them a lot of money. It's stealing almost, isn't it? Tricking people into buying something they think they want. It's just like women and makeup.
Yeah.
I'm not saying you can't enjoy it. But the reason you like it, that's not you. That's them.
Victory.
The way the masses buy into stuff that is so clearly designed to shut your brains off gets to me. It's like, you're only given so many seconds on this earth, and we all know that. There's no delusion. No one thinks they're living forever. And to know that...
Just wanna... Can't really read what's on the screen. Thanks, everyone who's...
And to willingly throw away time. Then diarrhea, a self-pitying diatribe on Facebook about how hard it is to be productive. What possesses people to do that?
The hammy next week. Fentanyl overdose at double dose here, so expect to make it easy. It's fun. Not everything has to be serious.
Yeah. Obviously not everything has to be serious. I'm not suggesting that. And when the not serious thing comes in and impedes
receiving this
actual,
email and you haven't
real,
yet done so.
Measurable progress, then people like Jim win. Oh, anyway, enough about Jim. Enough about his depoliticizing clickbait. He doesn't deserve the attention
in the coming months.
Helvetica, on the other hand. Did I ever tell you where all this came from and why? Why Helvetica?
Gotta dance.
I feel like I've put all the pieces down, but there's something holding me back.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's torturing me.
Yo,
I feel
what
exhausted
was that mortician's
all the
YouTube
time.
Channel get?
I'm well, constantly asked to work to give,
wow, she's leaning right into
give,
the
and for what?
It's
mindless
funny,
trifling,
like
ceaseless
it.
Backtalk from prosaic simpletons?
I'm taking
it's
it
just
to
so
this
difficult thing. For me to put my heart out.
Yeah, that's
so good. This is the brainchild of years of casual observation and more formalized research. It's the Helvetica of healthcare apps.
I'll confirm with MB and message you back. Thanks. Confirmed, I'll be there.
Helvetica? The typeface? It's the one that's captured the hearts of millions. And Helvetica will save those hearts. It's the companion piece to that minimalist sans-serif perfection.
It's a fun name.
It's not just a name, Carly. This isn't just some hip marketing campaign.
Yeah, Jim
I'm not trying to leech off the masses like Tractor Dad. I hate the blouse.
Yeah.
I hate the tractors. I hate the dads.
Look,
I don't
I
think
got...
you do. I don't think you understand just how much I hate it.
Well, let's start
and I don't
fresh.
Blame you. In many ways, you're
take
a part of
your free time.
You have such potential to rise above, but you haven't.
Are the police
I
on
want
to you?
You to see.
Yeah, nothing so dramatic, just need a fresh start. Time for working your brand again.
Oh. I'm not blaming you. It's important not to get trapped in this you-versus-me mentality. I know you're prone to that, but we're on the same side. Look, this isn't about you in the particular. This is more a criticism of me. Your views are not your own. They're constructed.
I don't think there's anything wrong with me.
And that's exactly what I'm saying.
Just finish.
It's not you, it's just everything about you.
An amazing book.
You're a product of the trends, just like Tractor Dad is, and just like Helvetica is not. Did you know Tractor Dad 3 was the top trending game for 12 consecutive weeks? Helvetica has not been given a dime. But that is the point. Don't you see? I'm trying to change the world. We are sinking as a people. I have the only boat, and no one wants to get on board. Where did I leave off here? Right. Helvetica bridges the gap between healthcare providers and patients. It's a marriage that these two groups shouldn't need an app for.
Not a real book. Do.
It's about tearing down.
Tearing down
everything.
What?
We have all these services, all these consultations, all these seminars where we try to disseminate and cure. But what happens? Still one health crisis after another. The market needs disruption. What if Helvetica was on the cloud? That would be a game changer.
Okay, I'm so sick of people. Some people. Have you given any thought to the interface?
Wow, Carl, you almost sound like you're into the biz. I must really be rubbing off on you, which is nice. It makes me feel like...
Dick.
Like I'm accomplishing something. With you. Together. Imagine this. Using variable statistics and actuary science, Helvetica could be able to predict serious health-related illnesses before they're even a reality.
How?
I just explained how. It's all very simple, or maybe just simple to me. I don't know.
10 must-have apps for nurses. I think there's some practical aspects you haven't
seen. What is this, an RFP? Look, I don't have all the facts on me, okay? I'm not ready to defend my thesis. I'm just looking for some support while I figure it all out. Can you do that?
I can't think right now. Can we talk about something else?
Sure. Speaking of which, my cousin Henry's wedding's coming. I think I've said this before, but I'd like you to come.
Woke up inspired, can't wait to share my idea with the world. But for now, it's you. Lacey and I are hitting the mall.
That's good, that's great. Lacey has exquisite taste. But do you know what you're going for? The theme, the thrust, the quintessence of your outfit?
I haven't thought about it yet.
The wedding is in 2 weeks, Carly.
You just told me about it. I know how to pick out clothes. I've been dressing myself for over 20 years.
Okay, but how many weddings have you been to?
Two.
Okay, but how about real weddings?
What? What is a real wedding?
Not your cousin's. You don't get married in a sundress. I mean, some people do, and I'm not against it. I'm not trying to shame anyone. However,
at that
my family does
my
shame everyone. And whether we or anybody else likes it, that's the game. Those are the rules we're playing here. It's the reality we live in. Judgment and shame are in the cards. And I don't agree with it. I think it's stupid and shallow and petty. And it's not you. You are amazing and beautiful and far kinder than anyone deserves. And I want them to see that, but they are so blind, it will take something of blinding class and propriety to get through their misogynistic skulls.
Sounds like this is very important to you.
It is.
The
you
medical.
Know what? That dress. Do you remember the one you wore on our second date? At that party where we met all those entrepreneurs and everyone was so fascinated and dazzled with you? You were enchanting and respectable. They couldn't stop asking questions about you and me with you and me. We were a hit.
I still have it.
Good. It would be a tragedy if you'd ripped it up or thrown it away.
Sounds like it.
Just know that when we get to Henry's wedding, though, there's going to be a barrage of questions. What am I doing? Where am I at? Where are we at? It'll be a torrential downpour.
Because patient care is going to be the problem. Does that bother you? Medical industry really needs to wake up to a shake-up because patient care is going down the toilet in this country.
No,
hearing
it
the
doesn't,
arguments I've
and
had,
why should it?
There are no
I
cats
know
here.
I have value. I partake in activities that are meaningful. Their understanding isn't needed or even desired. I find the whole song and dance frustrating. They want results. Results take time.
Grilled cheese. Give me grilled cheese. Barely had time to work on my project. So many obligations, but the world needs us app, so I'll persevere.
They have no patience. Ugh. Anyway, we figured out the attire. We don't need to indulge them anymore. I'm thankful to have this off my plate. Let's talk about something else. I still feel like my mind is spinning on Healthvetica.
Lament
what if Healthvetica
and
used big data? Imagine that.
Familiar theme explored on a variety of harmonic devices. How much more is there to go?
Everyone always wants to ask, how much code have you written? Where are the architecture nodes? Show me the diagrams. No one measures what you do.
Yeah, I guess, that tweet should give you an indication of the time frame that this game was written and takes place. Can we just impeach him already? Families keep new scrubs with monarch butterflies on them. Too expensive, though. Treat yourself, Mama-sa!
Do by how many lives you've saved.
Oh,
ingenuity can't be rushed, and its progress not reduced to numbers and reductively quantified into productivity. It's like how many men treat their partners in sex, like a race or a challenge. I'm not so easily egged on by my ego. Rome? Stonehenge? The pyramids of Egypt?
Just a friendly reminder that the model minority myth is rooted in anti-black racism and used to protect institutionalized white supremacy. Yep, that's a real thing. That is absolutely the kind of thing you see on Twitter. And beware of the health risks, night shift nurses.
Healthvetica? Those things weren't built in a day, never mind planned. Imagine this. By aggregating data from millions of diverse users worldwide, the app could make unprecedented predictions.
One-to-one pie eating contest. Isn't that just analyzing risk factors?
No, it's more than that. I mean, that's part of it for sure. But this would be an all-encompassing health database where people could include every piece of personal health information that they feel is relevant. And Healthvetica would factor it in. Make recommendations, change their life. It's all so vivid in my mind. Just talking about it here, with you, laying in bed with my eyes closed, it's almost palpable.
Had a dream last night I'd never imagined having. My ex asked me to forgive her, and it felt so good, it seemed so real. Woke up with a reality check, unfortunately. A fair number of these tweets come from people who backed the game on Kickstarter. Some were written specifically for the game, like some of the people who actually made the game wrote. Some were written by people who donated. Sometimes I wonder if they're even listening anymore. Anyway,
and I'm glad you're glad. I love you, Carly.
I
Now, let's talk about something else. Did you know my cousin has only known his fiance for 3 years?
I'm so excited the heart tricks are in town this weekend. And F. Nightingale is going with me. She never gets to go out anymore. Yeah, so this, obviously, this Healy person, this is, like, specific to the game. This was developers, writers.
How can anyone know after 3 years who it is they want to marry?
My parents got married after only 1 year.
Yes, I know. Role models.
Was that sarcasm?
Was that sarcasm? Really? No, of course it wasn't. It was very earnest, Carly. Really.
You don't have to be an asshole.
I'm not being an asshole. I'm sorry.
You are an asshole.
When I get married, though, it'll be with someone for whom I love deeply and who loves me deeply in return. I will be the pit they fall in. And in the chasm of my heart, there will be no...
I once broke up with someone with a pun. Can't say I regret it, considering I got off scot-free.
There was a girl before you. Jessica. Have I told you about her before?
More than
my family really wanted her and I to be together. Not because we were in love, but because it was proper. I was the right age. They see me as too old now. I feel old. Their expectations were on me. I felt like I was enveloped by a thick smog.
Best description of exploded torso.
I couldn't see, I couldn't breathe. How was I to focus on what I wanted?
What do you call a fly with no wings? A wop?
Right? Maybe things could have worked out with her. Maybe it could have been love. If it had been given a chance. And by that, I mean if they had given me a chance. Chance to see for myself.
Today's horoscope for Leos. You'll reconnect with an old friend. Try to see them in a new light, unbound by past perception.
That's on them. That is on them.
Good night. Well, we need feminism in the healthcare industry.
Cool. Anyway, okay. I don't want to talk about this anymore. Let's discuss something else. I want to talk about Helvetica.
Advertising is a service industry, too. You're just supporting things people don't need. Ouch.
What if Helvetica was open source? I could make it happen.
I know a programmer who could help.
Oh? Who?
An old friend from university.
Oh, I didn't know you still kept up with anyone from school. You've never mentioned him before.
Sometimes. It's not a big deal.
Okay, well, how is he at programming? If you can vouch for him, I really need a developer to help me get this off the ground. Actually, sorry, can we put a pin in that for a minute? I've got too many things in my head that I just want to get out there and see how they flow. Imagine this. By opening up the database to all contributors, coders from all backgrounds could contribute their unique perspectives on health science. No disease would be beyond capture.
Hmm.
Whew. I need some time to digest this. You know, my mom told me that they've paid to take the entire wedding party on vacation in Europe.
Oh, that sounds nice. I'll tell you a joke about UDP, but you might not get it. I know I don't.
How can you do that and still pretend something like that is love? It's just extravagance. Flaunting wealth. Do they think I'll be so easily impressed?
Mama.
Ugh. Anyway, okay. I don't want to talk about this anymore. Let's discuss something else. I still feel like my mind is spinning on Helvetica. What if Helvetica ran cross-platform? It'd be tough, but I'm sure there's an angle there.
Oh yeah, I too had a hookup phase. Tap shoulders, frantic whispers. What do you mean radios and servers don't count? I think this might already exist.
No, not like this. Helvetica is... it's so much grander than people think, so much more profound than they can know. It's almost ethereal, ephemeral. It escapes language, maybe even for me, and I made it.
Yeah, Josh is a douche. This guy at the drive-thru bought my coffee because I let him get in front of me at the light. Sweetie.
When it finally sees the light of day, people will know. They'll be able to feel something, even through the coarse plastic casings of their phones. I'll be vindicated. I just know it. I have to be.
I'd love to have
imagine
nice,
this.
Fresh coffee like
we'd right? No longer be limiting ourselves to a single class of users. No matter the phone, the tablet, hell, even the wearable, you could be contributing your data to the system. We could know exactly what's going on with your body.
Yeah.
I need some time to digest this. Carly, I hope you know that we're not going to have anything like my cousin's wedding. If we get married, we're just going to run off and have it done inside.
Proud of you. Probably
no pomp, no circumstance, and certainly no family. It will be just about us, you and me.
Sure.
No one else will matter. They can say what they want. I don't care.
Even if times seem desperate, know that when people care for you, they will be there for you.
Anyway, okay. I don't want to talk about this anymore. Let's discuss something else. I want to talk about Helvetica.
Come back to me.
What if Helvetica used NFC? That would be a game changer.
It's just going crazy over work and other things.
Imagine this. Other inventors, collaborators, employees, whoever could develop accessories that attach to your body and collect. I can't even imagine. The sky's the limit. Helvetica could be able to predict serious health-related illnesses before they're even a reality.
Hmm.
Whew. I need needed some time to digest this. It just riles me up to think that this could have been my wedding.
Can't wait.
Not that it matters. This is all just flash for show. Everything they do is for show. They are showing off to me, bragging to me. They want me to feel this way, you know? And I'm not going to give them the satisfaction.
Next guest is...
Anyway, I don't want to talk about this anymore. Let's discuss something else.
The best
I still feel like my mind is spinning on Helvetica. What if Helvetica was funded wholly through Patreon? Imagine that.
Burrowfest kicked me in the butt. Love it. And Mima 7, student loans, you are keeping me from an amazing
person. Imagine this. We wouldn't be subject to the whims of Big Pharma, yep, or Big Health or Big anything. We'd be us, just us. The app could make unprecedented predictions.
Today's horoscope for Pisces. Let it go, not all things should come back. Maybe that's true. I can't believe it. How could they be so short-sighted?
I need some time to digest this. You know, my mom told me that they've paid to take the entire wedding party on vacation in Europe?
Yeah, you mentioned
How
that.
Can you do that and still pretend something like that is love? It's just extravagance. Flaunting wealth. Do they think I'll be so easily impressed? Ugh.
I've had enough of this. This conversation.
All right, fine. I want to talk about Helvetica.
What
if I got
do.
Helvetica on Kickstarter? I could make it happen.
Arbitrary code execution is my new passion. Anyone want to nerd out? One woman conspiring to the story of the struggle of becoming an earth.
Imagine this.
My spirit animal is the honey
badger.
Users measure.
Would be invested before the app was even released. They could comment and tell us what they're looking for from Helvetica. People could share in my dream. No disease would be beyond capture.
Insanity. Rolling the same dice over and over again and expecting different results. Been a new game. Lesbian supervillain dating RPG.
This.
Here I come.
Carly, I hope you know that we're
Absolutely
not going to have anything
not.
Like my cousin's wedding. If we get married, we're just going to run off and have it done at City Hall. No pomp, no circumstance, and certainly no family.
That sounds
it be just
charming.
Outlaws, you and me. No one else will matter. They can say what they want. I don't care.
Paging off. Rock. The pieces start falling into place then it took.
What?
I want to break up with you.
What? What are you saying?
I think I need to break up with
think?
You.
Think? You think you want to break up with me? What is that? What am I supposed to do with that?
I don't want to keep doing this.
Doing what? Being together? Is this about Tractor Dad? What are you saying?
I want to break up with you.
Why?
You never actually listen.
I'm listening now.
I'm not talking about now.
Carly, geez, I'm so sorry. I just have a ton of stuff going on right now, and I know I get carried away sometimes. You know what? Not tonight. Now, we're talking about you.
Yeah, of course we are. Anyway, stream tomorrow night. Ocean landscapes like we are vibrant.
I want to listen. Tell me what's going on. How was your week?
Long.
So, how was work?
There was this guy.
He didn't see anything inappropriate to you, did he?
What?
Then
no.
Me.
Can you listen
to him? I am listening. I'm just mad at this guy. I don't like anyone who would hurt me. He needs to understand boundaries.
It wasn't that. We were having trouble with his insurance.
God, that's awful. The whole system is in complete disarray. The layers of bureaucracy and self-interested opportunists in the industry is nauseating.
He's not wrong. Okay, what did I miss? A revolution!
Just makes me sick, you know? What if Helvetica was on the cloud? It'd be tough,
what?
But I'm sure there's an angle there.
That's Netflix nerd theory. Whatever, dude. You know what? Mondays are so rough sometimes.
Imagine this. Using variable statistics and actuary science.
This one was me. No, you stayed up until 2 a.m. looking at Rokurokubi drawings. At the time the game came out, I was kind of really into Rokurokubis. They are a Japanese demon. They've got women. They're a woman with, or it's a woman with a really long neck. If you ever played Little Nightmares 2, or if you watched a Let's Play Little Nightmares 2, there's actually a Rokurokubi in that game. As a thing you have to keep running away from. Ray, Ray, yay, Ray. I'm not sure where I got the screen name from. I think I came up with the screen name as well, but I don't remember. Oh, I just noticed this. I'm guessing the K means Kickstarter comments.
Could know exactly what's going on with your body.
Moon is beautiful tonight. Reminds me of being a girl guide when I was older. Those were good times.
I need some time to digest this.
I know, right? I love going
It just
camping with
riles
people.
me up to think that this could have been my wedding.
I didn't know you
Not
were
that
a
it
girl guide.
matters.
You have
This
to
is
get
all
under
just
hiking boots
flash
now.
for show. Everything they do is for show. They are showing off to me, bragging to me. They want me to feel this way, you know? And I'm not gonna give them the satisfaction.
Okay, yeah, so.
What?
I want to break up with you.
Why are you doing this?
I'm tired of having my empathy
Oh
abused.
my God, I'm sorry. I am so, so sorry. I was just so enraptured with our conversation, I didn't realize how late it was. I know your shifts are all over the place in the hospital and you're probably bleeding. I should have asked you if you had to be in early today.
You've never
You
asked.
never told me something was wrong, and now that I know, I have to be honest, I feel awful. I just wish you told me earlier instead of letting this build up until it exploded. I feel as though I fucked up here, Carly, but I really feel like you should have made it known.
Is listening that
Excuse
hard?
me? Is listening so hard? Was listening so hard when we were on the beach that one time and you started sobbing about that woman who chided you just before dying on your shift at the hospital? Was listening so hard as you systematically divulged every hang-up you had in your previous relationships and made me sit through the stories of all the men who you slept with? Was listening so hard when your father was sick and no one knew if he was going to make it out alive?
Yeah, what a charming guy. Ugh, I need more coffee for this, and maybe a donut. I want to go back to bed.
Huh? Was listening in any of those cases so hard? Was it, Carly? I've been here, on the line, every time you needed me, okay? I have forced myself to be there for you.
Forced myself to be there for you.
I am
Well,
dating
thank
you
you.
despite you. Despite your therapist, despite your hang-ups, and despite your colored flaws.
Yeah, he's a charming fella. Wouldn't Harry Potter be so much better if Will Smith was Dumbledore? Cannot a lie pass my lie detector test, or will she reveal her deepest, darkest secrets to me?
Is listening so hard? It is hard sometimes, Carly. Sometimes I don't think you appreciate that, or me.
You've got your family, and I've got something in between. But thanks, I should get this.
Now, I'm guessing you want to break up with me. That seems to be the pattern tonight.
I'm sorry.
Carly, don't be sorry. I'm sorry. I should apologize. That was inappropriate. Let's move past this, okay?
Miri confirmed today that AI house in a Korean computing facility has achieved singularity. How will society change?
Let's not get hung up on this. We're a team.
Still pushing, but sometimes I feel like Sisyphus.
Let's talk about something else, okay? It'll be okay. Let's talk about something else. I still feel like my mind is spinning on Helvetica. What if Helvetica used big data? That would be a game changer.
Went to grab the bar on the bus to steady myself. Instead, I grabbed some guy's face. Bus encounter. Let's plug the Roadshow stories. Maybe I'll make my next article about the benefits of
Imagine
Road Guides
this.
of Canada.
By aggregating data from millions of diverse users worldwide,
First, but you know,
Helvetica
I mean,
could be able to predict serious health-related illnesses
sales.
before they're even a reality.
Good news, we have found Bean, the cat that went missing during the marriage proposal. Well done, team.
Whew.
that amazing.
Some time to digest this
weekend.
You know, my mom told me that they've painted
meeting
the entire wedding party on vacation in Europe. How can you do that and still pretend something like that is love?
They'll sleep in each other.
It's just extravagance, flaunting wealth. They think I'll be so easily impressed.
Discovered a lot of cool new indie games at the convention. Love. I've had the song stuck in my head all day, but I don't remember anything.
Anyway, I don't want to talk about this anymore.
Yeah, that sucks.
Let's discuss something else. I want to talk about
Plush parties this weekend.
What if Helvetica was open source?
Payday's not until Tuesday.
Imagine that.
Guess Black America will have to do. Oof. Sometimes you can be too helpful. Do I need to see the escape artist?
Imagine
this. Got spoiled for me?
By opening up the database to all contributors, coders from all backgrounds could contribute their unique perspectives on health science. The app could make unprecedented predictions.
I just bought this adorable new kit. We've decided to name her Muffin. Aww. What am I even doing anymore? Is everything okay? Playing heart.
I need some time to digest this.
I've got something important.
Carly,
to
I call. Hope you know that we're not going to have anything like my
husband. Not drinking enough gin.
If we get married, we're just going to run off and have
we all need to go together like we used to.
No pomp, no circumstance, and certainly no family.
We made an announcement for Kitchener Waterloo. The bus petition has now been upgraded to Hail Mary Face.
They can say what they want. I don't care.
I'm guessing there is some stuff going on in Kitchener Waterloo at that point. Best time to break out that celebratory champagne.
Anyway, I don't want to talk about this anymore.
I picked up a frosted red velvet cupcake from the pudding and pie bakery.
I still feel like my mind is spinning on Helvetica. What if Helvetica ran cross-platform? I could make it happen.
All right, so I've finished up with all this stuff.
Imagine this. We'd no longer be limiting ourselves to a single class of users. No matter the phone, the tablet, hell, even the wearable, you could be contributing your data to the system.
The war continues.
No disease would be beyond capture. Hey, Carly, are you actually there? Something must be wrong with the phone. One sec. Hey, I think we got disconnected.
That's not it. I don't think this is working.
I'm starting to see a pattern with you.
A pattern with me?
Yeah. You told me, word for word, that you have a pattern of being avoidant, distant, and have a history of isolating behavior. Isn't that what you said?
I told you that in trust.
And I haven't told anyone. I'm trying to demonstrate my sympathy and support. You said you wanted to grow, and I'm trying to help you get there. Don't shut me out.
You're using this against me.
Carly, the only thing I care about right now is your well-being, your health. You work at the hospital. You see sickness every day, but that is just flesh. And that's what you know. You're amazing at that. But there's another health, and that's what you have to face. So you've been going to counseling for about 3 years now? That's essentially individual therapy, yes?
Uh-huh.
So, in that time, what progress have you made? I don't want you to tell me, I just want you to think about it. Do you understand me? Is this making sense to you? I just want you to take a moment to reflect on this for me. In individual counseling, the goal is to help individuals address and overcome various negative, impactful behaviors, overcome negative cognitions, and replace this with newer, more positive cognitions and behaviors. Are you following me?
Uh-huh.
Great. So can you not agree that by avoiding this discussion, you are doing exactly what you do every time we have one of these talks, which is simply continuing a pattern of negative behaviors? I mean, I hate to say this, but in a way, you're kind of textbook. Good.
Fine.
Very good. I know it doesn't feel like much right now, but these really are important first steps. Phew, that was exhausting. Anyway, we can keep talking now. It just riles me up to think that this could have been my wedding. Not that it matters. This is all just flash for show. Everything they do is for show. They are showing off to me, bragging to me. They want me to feel this way, you know? And I'm not gonna give them the satisfaction. What?
I want to break up with you. What? I'm the tractor now.
I'm tired of this. You owe me a real goddamn reason.
You treat me like
I was trying to make you passable, okay, Carly? I was trying to make sure my family would love you. You don't get how they are, these people. You don't get how they make you feel, how they keep you weak and broken and dependent so they can control you. I was going to save you from all that. It was never about anything more. Because I don't need their approval. I have the girl, I have the educated ideas. I read Gizmodo. You hear that, Mom, Dad, Henry? I don't need you.
You are just like-
You know what? I don't need you, Carly. You are a mess, you know that? A hot, steaming pile of garbage, junk, trash, leaking bag, oozy mess thing. You just want somebody to come in, collect your shit, and clean you up? I was doing that. I was taking on that burden. I was your white knight. But no, that wasn't good enough for you. Your demands are impossible. No man is ever going to be able to foot this bill. I am the best you can hope for. Just think about what it would be like to be alone. To come home and have no one to call. To go to sleep and not have me hovering over you. To wake up to silence instead of all the thoughts I have spent the night crafting for you. But you know what? Now I am ending it. So look in the mirror, Carly. Because that's going to be the only other face you get to look at in the morning. And when you've had to live with that for a few months, maybe you'll know what I've endured.
Okay, bye.
No, bitch. You're gonna let me finish. You are a mess, you-
Nah, I'm not gonna let you finish. The fuck, really? She's been so testy recently, I don't know what's happened to her. Always the quiet, sweet-looking ones. Barf. I gotta hear her side, but really? There's a time and place, sis. Yeah, block him. Getting obvious. Is this a period thing? None of my business, but like, frigid cold, man. You deserve better. Women like that need to get their bras loosened. Alright, and now all these are going, a lot of these are once again going to be from good, I hated his eyebrows. Girlfriends, man, they are vicious! Now you can focus on the most important person in your life. You. And then, yeah, we're about to get into a bunch more Kickstarter comments here. I'm proud of you for doing right by yourself. I know it must be so hard. I also know you'll get through this, and I'll be right here if you need me. Hey, Carly. I saw that what that asshole Josh is saying about you. You should know that not everyone believes what he's spouting. I certainly don't. And that you have people on your side. People like him will make themselves miserable in the end. If you need anything from me, just let me know. I'm around. Any dude who would do something like that isn't worth your time. You're too good for him anyway. Stay strong. Hey, Carly, you're probably hurting a lot right now, but I just want to let you know that if you need a shoulder to cry on, or you need to vent, or you need anything at all, I'm here for you. Maybe we can go shopping together this weekend. None of what has happened is your fault. And one day you'll meet somebody who is truly will truly appreciate you for the kind, caring, and amazing person you are. Oh, Carly, I'm so sorry that you have to deal with all his nonsense. At least it shows how much better off you are without him. There's plenty of fish in the sea, and they're all better in bed than Josh. You keep being you. Hey, I hear you broke up with Josh. You okay? Let me know if you need to talk. You're stronger than his bullshit. Berry picking tomorrow? Want to come over tomorrow? Here's me again. Your ex is a jerk. Say the word and I'll egg his house. And his face. You know, in retrospect, the fact that I was using Ray, which is generally a woman's name, That was a difficult thing you did. How are you feeling? I'll pick up some burgers and be there in 20. Fries or onions? Just saw your sorry ex's post about how you broke up with him. Good for you. Josh might be saying terrible things about you, but he's just showing his colors of how much of a loser he is. Proves he wasn't a keeper, and this makes him seem like a little kid having a tantrum. Besides, love, be kind and patient. Love, be kind and patient, all that jazz. Didn't know how you could make a relationship with him work when he never seemed to respect you and your needs. Take care of yourself, and always know my door is open if you need to talk. I'll be prepping for tomorrow's stream, so I'll be up until the sun rises, probably. I'll delay or even cancel if you need to just escape and hang for a bit. You may need to hold my flower dear. I hate to say I told you so, but I told you that you deserve better than that. And that's something me and none of your friends will ever grow tired of saying. Hey, on Wednesday, let's go to one of the new bakeries which just opened up recently. My treat. Hey, it's going to be all right. If you need anything, please message me. You okay? If you're feeling social, we should get some ice cream. My treat. If you'd rather have some me time, I do have a suggestion for a fantastic video game I think you would enjoy. Take care of yourself. All the hugs. And I saw the Twitch post. I hope you're doing okay. Call me if you need to talk. I promise not to mention anything I might have asserted previously. And pretty much ended here. Except
hey, Carly. I just saw. I want to say I can't believe someone would do something like that, but well, in Josh's case, I can. Good for you. I'm glad you dropped that loser. He was a skunk, and to say you could do better would imply he registers on the scale at all. And if you're not convinced he's a loser, if you're lying awake wondering if you're the crazy one or he is, let me make it easy. Remember when I lost my job about a year ago? 2 weeks after, I got a message from Josh. He was upset because the two of you were on the outs, and he said that the real reason, not any of the ones you told him, was that I was overwhelming you with the emotional weight of my problems because we got coffee that one time. Coffee! I didn't reply, I just hit delete. But that's the sort of shit he'd say. I think I told you about it, but you dismissed it as his anger getting the best of him. I don't blame you. I get it. That's how brains work. But focus on that memory now. It's the true him. Garbage. And if he doesn't smell like that to you, if you're still having doubts, just give me the word and I'll spit roast him over a dumpster fire and baste him in it. Then there'll be no confusion at all. Lots of love, Carly. I miss you. Give me a call.
So I was unaware, but there are multiples of that ending message. Because I've heard, I've seen other versions of that. Like that's the first time I saw that message. Give me a second. I'm going to try to get another message here. Give me 1 second. Let's see if I get a different voicemail this time. Not sure how many voicemails there are. At least two, clearly. I sort of speed ran that breakup. You can see the clock there, like 12:04.
Carly, Josh is being a total douche. I have my laptop packed, and if you want, tomorrow we can meet up and I can help you delete those messages and block all of those nasty people who are replying to you. The same thing happened to Rachel last year, so I have all the privacy and spam settings figured out. I've also got some home-baked cookies, tissues, and Barbara is out of town all week, so the apartment will be empty except you and me. You can stay here if you want, because I know last time I had to do what you did, my whole apartment felt icky for like 2 weeks. But if all that is too much, I totally get it, and we can rain check for whenever is better. I can handle the social media stuff either way. You shouldn't have to deal with all that yourself. I love you, Carly. I'll send you another message tomorrow to check in. Heart, heart, heart. Make sure to take care of yourself. Love, Melted.
All right, so I'm not sure how many of those messages there are. That one I think I've gotten before. I know there is at least one more. I'm not going to go looking for it. Where somebody who Carly apparently hasn't spoken with in a while calls her up and invites her out to the coast or something like that, to a cabin, hang out with a bunch of friends at a cabin, something like that. So. So. Yeah, that is, It's You, a Breakup Story. Not so much a game, as it is just a narrative experience. I like it, but I should certainly hope I would, considering I paid for it. And, yeah, I mean, it's a good depiction of a toxic relationship. He's not, there's obviously no indications that he's physically abusive. And, not really, and even not even really verbally abusive until certain points, but, he is manipulative, he's controlling, he's jealous, he does engage in nagging. One of the things you can accuse him of is nagging, and he sort of flips out at that. He flips out of being accused of engaging in nagging. He hates that idea. I don't think I got the, I didn't really get the, this part where he starts talking about being an asshole, but depending on sort of your dialogue choices, he can, start engaging in performative self-flagellation, for lack of a better term, where he just starts talking about, like, how garbage he is, and all that, basically trying to force you to forgive him. So, there's, just sort of a lot going on in the game. As far as all that stuff goes. And, I think that it does a good job at depicting a toxic relationship. And, so showing how it can be toxic without being violent, so Yeah, I just figured
I'd throw this in here.
Do a quick play of this one. Throw it up. And next time we'll get back to Mass Effect. Yeah, let me know what you thought of the game. Let me know... If it feels sort of authentic to the experiences you've had or anything like that. So, yeah, we can always use the comments to for people to talk about their own experiences with toxic boyfriends, or toxic partners, I should say. Doesn't necessarily have to be boyfriends, but toxic relationships. Feels like I hope you enjoyed it. Feels like sort of the wrong phrasing given what the game is about. But I hope you did at least get something out of it, I suppose. Either way, like I said, let me know what you thought. For right now, this is a good place to end it, so thank you for watching, and I'll see you in another video, I hope.